1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hey, boo. What you doing? You ready to go to work? Look at me. Hey, boo. Come on. Let's go to work. Don't flick your tail at me. It's time to work. We all have to work for a living. You got to direct a video. Come on. Come on. Don't flick that tail at me. And here's the last of drill I received in that lot of drills. They were old, dirty. Included that nice redhead drill and another drill that I'll show you that I restored. This one is grimy, hard to turn. Of course, there's so much grease and goop on here, I can understand that. But it does have a handle on it with a little chamber with some drill bits in it. Rusty drill bits, of course. And we'll have to work on restoring that. There's not a name on here, but you don't know till you get these things cleaned. One might appear. I've looked over it carefully and haven't found one so far, but it seems like a fairly nice drill, so I would imagine that the maker would have wanted to put his mark on here. So we'll get it apart and restore it and see what we got. Well, the initial tear down is done. As you can see from just shaking off some of the loose dirt on here, this is really grimy. So we're definitely going to need to give this thing a good bath and Dawn, because it's a greasy film, oil and dirt and grease, and we'll see if we can't get the rest of it off, and it'll help with ease the rest of the restoration. So here's our post wire brush evaluation. Of course, the chuck cleaned up nicely with the wire brush. The handle cleaned up and polished. The wood's been sanded. The frame clean, the wood sanded. It's a nice brass ferrule on here. A couple of things to do. First of all, look at that terrible finish on the casting. That's one of those terrible grind jobs where they just gouged it and really did a terrible job. I know this item was painted, so it tended to cover some of that up. But I definitely want to smooth that out, file it and sand it down before painting. Don't know what color I'm going to do this frame. I've got some done in a natural color, some kind of a silver, and some in the black. So we'll have to see. Haven't decided yet. We'll see how that comes out. Then, of course, the wheel here, the gear wheel. Best we can get out of it with the wire brush. We're going to have to get down individually in here with the Dremel or probably and clean all that paint out of here. Couldn't get further into that down inside. The wheel itself was pretty dark and dingy. I shined it up and buffed it, and it looks pretty good. So I don't know what color I'm going to do this. Most of them I've done red. I just did one in a black. Depends on what I do for the frame, so we'll have to make that decision. But we're getting there. Ready for some final finish. And here's the finished drill. Did something a little different on this one. My others seem to be a metal or silver colored frame like this one with a red gear. And I decided to do this a little differently, so I did a black. Actually, I did a satin black, not a shiny glossy black. I think it looks a little better. and with a red orange paint that I've used on so many tools, get away from just the typical red. Shined and polished the crank, the handle that has a compartment in for bit storage. Stripped that down, sanded it, and again, is old wood on these tools turns out just beautifully. They've got just a nice pattern to them, and they do turn out nice. Had a nice brass ferrule, a brass one here on the turning knob, and shined up the chuck. It wasn't working, got it working again. It actually opens and works correctly. So just a different look from the traditional red, and it turned out very nice. It'll be a nice wall hanger. And here's another hand drill from that collection we bought. This one is a no-name brand. Same conditions as all of them, rusty, pitted. Wood's not in good shape. The chuck working really rough and pretty corroded too. So we'll take this one down and maybe try to come up with a different paint scheme than we did on the other ones and see what we can do with it. Oh, in addition, try the drill out. Listen to this. That's going to need some work too, so we'll get that working smooth. Well, here's the teardown of the drill. A few more parts than most of them. Actually, the turning wheel here, the gear, instead of a screw holding it in place, it had a shaft on it, and then a little teeny tiny set screw holding it in place. Another thing on the outside of the wheel, there was a little tab that kept it in place too. So had some extra parts I usually don't see and some tiny little ones. That's why I've got them in this magnetic tray. I'm famous for losing them. And of course, those parts are hard to find. We're going to need, this will be a little easier to clean up with the complete disassembly. So we'll get to work on the cleanup now. And here's the final on this tool. And again, I did something a little different. Refinished the chuck. The handle turned out real nice. Very nice. I did find, didn't find a name on it here. But it has a nice brass ferrule. I did just the plain metal finish on the frame. But I did the gear in a black. Haven't done a black before. I've always done them in primarily red or natural color, but primarily red. And to get away from the red, we'd have a couple of them today where we did one in black and one in a red-orange to give the tools a different look. And there's the completed projects for the day. Two Eggbeater drills. A little different colors, but still looking nice. Thanks for watching my video. Of course, all the drills are finished, and we're going to put them on the wall. Lots of pretty items. Took a lot of reshuffling of the clamps and other items to make room, but I definitely think they need a place of honor on the wall. And there we go.